Hello, the book that I've taken for the review is Alternative Realities by Nigat M. Gandhi. So this book is basically about love in the lives of Muslim women. The author herself is a Muslim woman and she wants to portray how Muslim women are seen around the world and how their lives are being sometimes taken for granted and sometimes have to be hard earned. So this book is all about how the author herself tries to find what she is and who she is, and also in the part and in the way of finding herself, she also wants to break the silence of how the sexuality, the choice of partners and choice of life of Muslim women is being taken into account in a family, especially in a Muslim community in and around the world. So she would have eloped from her family, from her native, to marry the man of her life. So that's where she starts introducing herself. So this is how the story goes. It starts with a narration of how her house is and how her family would treat every woman in their family. So, and how she had found that this is not her place and this is not her calling, and she found her love of her life away from her home and community. And also she after marrying and after some years, she would have realized that she doesn't want to settle down to be a housewife or someone who's just depends on the family or the man she had been married to. So then she would take up this work of exploring the sexuality, the love, the lives of other Muslim women in and around the world. And this narration, this book would be mostly like a travelogue, a memoir and a biography, because she would have traveled to so many places to know about her friends of friends and family and all. So this is like a travelogue. To be a memoir, she wanted to make a stand for the Muslim women she found in this traveling. And a biography, because she would have found herself and she would have seen herself layering and how she get to know herself in every time and everyone she meets. Because she would have met many men and also many women who would have courageously came out of their beliefs and superstitions and wanted to lead their own life. Even if it is a married woman or someone who is still a bachelorette and like that. Also, she would have seen that most of the women would have chosen to work or chosen to have to make a stand in their family because they wanted to have an identity rather than being suppressed and wanted to be treated as a slave. So it's not just about the particular community or something, but this is an example, like this is a portrayal of women around the world from different communities, countries and different whatever. So if we read through the book, we will realize how insane and how mean we people are to the fellow mates in this world. And starting from the religious beliefs to everyday chores or many things like that. For example, even if a marriage is conducted or marriage is done to a woman in a community, it's not according to her will. Also, if the marriage is according to her will, the planning of the family, like number of children and when to have children, if she wants to go to a job or if she wants to go to a job, what kind of job, where, when, like that, all these questions have to be answered. And she has to face so much hurdles to come out of such a patriarchy and misogyny. So I would recommend this book particularly for everyone. And you may think she is a feminist, but you will realize that everyone is a feminist in themselves. But also, feminism is not just supporting women to do whatever a man does, but it is also respecting a woman as a co-mate in this world, and she too has her own interests and rights to live in this world. And please do read it and enjoy and start treating women equally. Thank you.